The next radio-controlled car that I got from my sponsor Gearbest and that I have transformed to a remote-controlled rover is a vehicle named UJ99-2815B. The toy car ships with a remote control in pistol grip design and a USB charger. The dimensions are 22x15x10cm and the total weight is approximately 430 grams. It costs less than 20 euros, but what this is an extremely cost-efficient base for a working robot car. In original configuration it is radio controlled, two AA batteries that are not included in the package are needed for the controller. The drive battery is composed of 4 nickel-cadmium cells with a total voltage of 4.8 volts and a capacity of 700 mAh. That battery is placed in a box at the bottom of the car, the cover is fixed with a screw and a matching screwdriver is included. The locking mechanism of the plug is a bit fiddly. The battery is charged through a USB cable. The red LED is turned off after approximately 3 hours, indicating that the battery is fully charged. Turn on the remote control and the car to start operating the vehicle. The control is all or nothing. With the trigger you can turn on the drive motor into forward direction, turn the motor off, or turn it fully into reverse direction. As you can see, only the rear wheels are driven. The steering is all or nothing as well, going fully right, straight, or fully left. Especially when steering to the left I had to turn the plastics wheel forcefully to the end switch. As a consequence I had to repair the steering wheel with some drops of super glue during my test drives because the plastics cracked. You can put the steering wheel on the opposite side and reverse the steering with the control switch so that you can control the car left or right handed. With a tiny lever you can trim the steering. So let's start a test drive in original configuration. The top speed is listed with 20 km/h, which is enough for the tiny car, especially if your kids drive it indoor, crashing into your furniture. The off-road capabilities aren't great, however you can drive outdoor if the terrain isn't too rough. The battery capacity is sufficient for 10 to 15 minutes of driving fun before you must go back to the charging station. Before starting the conversion from boy's toy to man's tool, let's have a closer look at the mechanics. The steering is driven by a DC motor that is blocked mechanically at the left or right end position. It's a simple, reliable construction, but the motor draws the full stall current from the battery whenever the steering is enabled. The rear wheels are connected through a hexagon rod and driven by a second DC motor. The plastic gears of the transmission seem to be large enough for many miles of driving fun. For the conversion I got a Raspberry Pi Model 3 with a camera module from my sponsor. Furthermore I'm using a DC converter to get a constant input voltage of 5 volts for the Raspberry Pi. You can use the power electronics or the model car to control the drive and steering. I couldn't find a datasheet or the chips on the board, so I had to guess and gauge. The large chip is obviously for the radio transmission, while the 4 tiny chips are the switches for drive and steering that have to be connected to the Raspberry Pi. By following the tracks you can see that the steering is connected to only one of the chips, while the drive motor is controlled by 3 of them that are obviously H bridges. Those bridges are controlled by 2 input channels and these are the pins we must find. The voltage at those pins must be zero whenever a motor is turned off, while the potential at one of them is on high level whenever that motor is turned on. The steering motor is obviously connected to pins 5 and 8, which are the output pins. Another look at this chip makes clear that pins 6 and 7 are joined, these are very likely ground pins. Pin 1 is not connected to the board. We can read the full battery voltage at pin 4 even while the motor is turned off, this must be the pin for the positive supply voltage. With that, only pin 2 and 3 are left as input pins. There is no voltage while the steering motor is turned off. When turning the remote control to the left, we can read 3.25 volts at pin 2. While that voltage is zero when turning the remote to the right. We can read 3.25 volts at pin 3 when turning right. And 0 volts when turning left, with that we figured out what pins are the inputs. Same as the Raspberry Pi, the microcontroller on the board uses logic levels of 3.3 volts, so there is no need for level conversion. You must remove the microcontroller from the board or else the outputs of this chip will drive contrary to the GPIOs of the Raspberry Pi, which will cause damage. Check if you did not bridge any traces while desoldering the chip. Also check if you did not bridge any pins while soldering the wires on the input pins or the H bridges. With the multimeter switch to continuity, you can check if there is no conductive path between the pins or the H bridge. I'm using 1 kilo ohm resistors covered with shrinking tube to avoid damage of the Raspberry Pi in case something went wrong with the soldering work. Some hot glue keeps mechanical stress away from the soldering points. While the H bridges are connected directly to the battery, you must use a DC converter for the Raspberry Pi. I am using an adjustable converter, so you must make sure the output voltage is indeed 5 volts before connecting the Raspberry Pi. To avoid deep discharge, the battery voltage should not drop below 3.6 volts. I am using a voltage divider composed of 3 resistors and 2 potentiometers to sense the battery voltage. 3 points of the voltage divider are connected to GPIOs of the Raspberry Pi with pull-up or pull-down resistors being disabled by software. The voltage divider is adjusted in such a way that the reading at one of the GPIOs is 2.02 volts at a battery voltage of 4.75 volts. More about how to adjust that sensor is written on my pages. Last thing to add is a headlight, I am using 8 LEDs, switched in 2 groups. The Raspberry Pi draws a current of approximately 300 mA. In idle mode, the current through the drive motor is approximately 500 mA, while the stall current is up to 4 amps. As said before, the steering motor draws the stall current whenever the end position is reached, we can read 1 amp. The headlight draws no more than 50 mA. When reducing the power of the drive motor by pulse width modulation to 50%, we can read 4 to 500 mA in idle mode and no more than 1.7 amps of stall current. A planetary probe is no racing car, so you can save energy when reducing motor power. You can mount all parts on the chassis with cheap fiberboard, as I did for the first test drives. It all looks much better if you have a 3D printer to create a mount plate. You can get the schematics, 3D files as well as the software on my pages. I've also created a circuit layout using cheap H bridges instead of the tiny chips on the board of the model car, which makes soldering less fiddly. I have replaced the drive battery with 4 standard AA nickel metal hydride cells having a capacity of 1900 mAh. The battery holder is 3D printed as well, because commercially available battery boxes are too large. The 4 battery cells fit into the box at the bottom of the car. A cover protects the electronics from rain if you go for outdoor missions. It's 3D printed as well and the box shaped bodywork has lots of space for stickers. With that, the conversion is done and now you can remote control the robot through a browser interface. Here I'm using a smartphone. This is my Rover number 7 and same as its predecessors you can drive it in my Robo Spadium. Have a test run. The capacity of the batteries is good for an operating time of 2 hours, thus this robot isn't online all day long, however you can get a notification through Twitter whenever a mission starts. Other robots in my Robo Spadium run on mains power, so that there's always an explorer waiting for you. There is no registration needed and it's free of costs, at least for you, but if you'd like to support me in keeping my robots rolling, you can make a donation on my pages. Many thanks to all existing supporters. The rover made of this cheap RC car is very compact and the total weight, including the batteries, is just 500 grams, so this is a great prototype for my planetary probe. A successor of Rover number 7 will expand the frontiers of my Robo Spadium to a whole planet, stay tuned to learn more about that project. Thanks for watching and I'll be back!